Hi, and welcome to the sixth video about the DevSecOps pipeline, which we are implementing with GitLab. In today's video, we will look at container scanning. In this video series, we are implementing a DevSecOps pipeline, which you can see here. In our last videos, we have already implemented software composition analysis, where you can see the video up there. And we have implemented license compliance, which you can see in this video up there, and static application security testing, which you can see in this video up there. In today's video, we will look at container scanning, which is also a static analysis, which we are implementing here in our GitLab pipeline. So Padi, what is container scanning?
Well, container scanning is all about finding vulnerabilities within your container images. So container image scanning is interesting when you use Docker containers to run your code. Container image scanning works only for Linux, so Windows images are not yet supported. The container scanning feature is a GitLab ultimate feature, and it is implemented like this. It scans all the files within your image for known vulnerabilities or security issues. It uses the Trivy and Gripe open source tools to accomplish this. Please note that this might lead to duplicates with the SCA scanning we performed before. However, when you have an Ultimate license, Ultimate can filter out these duplicates for you.
That's very cool. I assume, like in the other videos which we have done, it is just adding one line of code. But Padi, do we already have a Docker image?
Absolutely correct, Romano. We just need to enable our container scanning job in gitlab-ci.yaml, as we did it also for SUST, for example. Only this time, we need the file containerscanning.gitlab-ci.yaml that's also provided from GitLab in their repository. But you're absolutely right, we also need a Docker image first that we can actually scan. So in order to create an image, we first need a Docker file as input. So while we already got a Docker file when initially creating the project, we have to override that and improve it. Instead of just rebuilding everything in the Docker file and creating the image, then we kind of use the application that we built in the pipeline. This is done by the copy target command we see in the Docker file. We then use this copied app jar to run it. That's the last entry in the Docker file. Besides the Docker file, we also need to instruct our pipeline to actually do something with this Docker file. This is done by extending the build image job. The build image job is a default job that comes with the container scanning template we introduced before. We first define a variable container test image that contains the name of the pushed image. Building is as simple as adding a script file that executes some Docker commands. These commands include logging to Docker as well as then kind of building the actual Docker image and pushing it to the GitLab repository. Please note, as we've assigned this job also to the build stage, We therefore have to introduce a dependency. This is done by the needs statement at the very end of the file. So we need the build job before we can actually run the build image target. Now, to have the Docker tooling available to us within our build process, we need to introduce a service called Docker in Docker. We can do that by adding the services section within the GitLab CI.yaml file for the build image job. And last but not least, when we actually created the image and our container scanning job is ready to run, we need to tell the container scanning job what image it should check. We do this by setting a predefined variable called Docker image to the name of the image we defined before.
Poor Paddy, this is quite a lot of things we need to do. You need to show me that in code.
Sure. So let's first take a look at the Docker file we got when creating the initial repository by means of GitLab template project. As you can see, the original version includes a Maven package command, which means it recompiles the whole application. We will improve this now. So instead of just rebuilding everything, we reuse the application we compiled in the build step in our pipeline before. We then execute this char file as part of the Docker image. And as runtime environment for our Docker image, we use a JDK 13 image as starting point. The next thing is we add the import statement to our GitLab CI file. As before, I just add it to the list of imports. Now I add the variables we will need. Remember these two variables we saw before. Container test image is the name of the image we create in the repository. So when we push to the repository, it will have this name. The Docker image variable actually contains the name of this image, and this variable is part of the container scanning job we imported. So with this variable, we advise the container scanning job that it should use this image and scan this image for vulnerabilities. I next add the build job for our image. As mentioned, we first import the services like docker-dynd. Remember that these few lines make the Docker tools available to our job. We've assigned building the image to the build stage, but we need access to the compiled char. That's why we have defined the needs requirement at the very end of the file. So this statement makes sure that first the build job is run, and only after the build job finished, then the build image job runs. And this is the reason why we defined the copy target here. So we need this last statement because we require it here. Let's head back to the GitLab pipeline definition. In the script section, you see how we actually create the Docker image and push it to the registry by the name of container test image. So the container test image is then used also by the container scanning job, because we defined at the very beginning in the variables section the Docker image variable for the container scanning job. And with this, we finally have everything together we need, and we can commit this extension.
Oh, wait a minute, Padi. So these are quite a lot of Docker images which we have at the moment. So let's quickly recap. So first, we have our build jobs. Each build job is executed in its own Docker image. And now we also created a new Docker image where our application is running in. And this new Docker image where our application is running in, this will be scanned by the container scanning of GitLab. Did I get that right, Paddy?
Absolutely. Great.
Cool.
So let's see what our pipeline did. We see here that we have an additional job, container scanning, that actually went through. Looking at the details, we see the following. Looks like the job was successful and it actually found some vulnerabilities in here.
Wait, Paddy, the job is successful, but it found vulnerabilities, and we also saw that it was successful, but we have vulnerabilities. Why is the pipeline not red?
It's actually a very good question. And I guess the answer here is GitLab decided that a job is successful when it could do its job, actually. For the container scanning job, this means it could run through everything, scan the container image file and report some vulnerabilities it found. This also means that this job will not break our pipeline as long as it can run to the end.
So, okay, that's quite interesting. But now we have a pipeline which is green and we have vulnerabilities. Where do I see all of these vulnerabilities? How do I deal with these vulnerabilities?
Good catch, actually. From a security point of view, as a security engineer, I'd be more than happy if the pipeline would fail as soon as one vulnerability is found. However, from a practical point of view, we nearly always have one or the other vulnerability. So it would be very hard to actually get the green pipeline. One good option would be now to limit to a certain severity, like major or high risks, for example. But this is something that GitLab currently does not support. As a remediation for this, we will see later that we can do merge requests with security in mind. So when doing a merge request, we can define that we need certain requirements regarding additional security vulnerabilities that came in. And we may require approval by a given set of users if we want to bring in additional security issues. We will look at merge requests and the capabilities there in a later session and video. Now let's see where we can take a look at the vulnerabilities that we found. First, directly on the pipeline, we again have the security tab. Here we can filter by tools. In our case, we're interested for the container scanning tool. And as we see, yes, here we have quite a few security issues also in our container image. The other location where we can see our vulnerabilities is in the governance section. Security compliance and then vulnerability report. Also here I can sort and filter by tool. As mentioned before, we will look at how we manage vulnerabilities in GitLab in another session.
So that was very interesting. So when we look at the container scanning, then again, it was only one line which we needed to add for enabling the container scanning. But to scan a container, we needed a container. And for that, we added a container that we can scan with the container scanning. Then we created a build job to build the container, and then the container scanner was scanning our container. And this concludes this video about container scanning. In our next video, we will have a look at Dust, which is Dynamic Application Security Testing.